Hi guys, and welcome to the channel. I am Marv. This is readings by Marvelous Madame Tarot. This is going to be your December 2023 how do they see you reading for the collective. Everything you need is below in the description box for you and your collective. This is a collective energy read. It will not be zodiac related. I am going to advise on your end, this is going to be a podcast style reading. Please turn your volume or adjust your volume on your end, because I clap, bang, maybe talking loud, whatever it is, and I don't want to kill your eardrums with me. All right. Everything you need is below and is below in the description box for you and your collective. You will also be receiving in a couple of days your weekly energy read from the 10th through the 17th. That's going to be in the energy of what's the tea. We're going to be changing it. So I was very excited. You're going to start to see those trickling in. But right now, we're going to get into how they see you. If you're interested in this particular reading and you want to go and catch up last month to see what the energy was, you can definitely go and do that. The November 2023, how do they see you reading is up as well. And let's get started. So we're going to go over several different spots. I'm going to first get all of the energy out, read the cards intuitively, then we will clarify. You guys know the deal. So I'm going to do a couple more shuffles, and then I'm going to call out each card so you understand. All right. How do they see the collective? No. That's not the first one. Oh, my goodness. That's not what we're doing. Spirit, what is the true collective energy? The person that is listening, who I am reading this for, please give me a card that represents the true them. The true them. Please. Okay. Two of Wands. Please give me a card that represents the true partner. Oh, that's interesting. The Ten of Cups. All right. How do they see the collective? Interesting. How does the collective see them? All right. So we got too many on this one. Too many. So they see you in the energy of the Hangman. Again, I'm going to continue to go and get everything that we need. How does the collective see the person, the other person? Oh, wow. That's interesting. Okay. What happened in this relationship in the past? All right. Give me the present energy. Okay. And then give me a card that represents the future. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. All right, so the true you right now, collective, is an individual who is in the Two of Wands. You are in some type of transitionary state in your life. You're in an energy of thinking ahead, looking ahead, and you may feel like you're at a crossroads, okay? The Two of Wands is an energy where you are looking out, well, symbolically, you're looking out on the horizon and you're trying to figure out which way you're going to go, okay? What you're going to do. Are you going to move forward or aren't you going to move forward? It seems that you may find yourself in a little bit of a crossroads right now. So the true you, basically, with this card is an individual who is a little bit cautious, collective. You want to make sure that you wait before you make a decision. You don't like to rush into things, which unfortunately could have made you slow to act in certain areas where you should actually act. Okay. It could mean that There has been things, again, that you needed to take action on, but instead you decided that you're going to be a little bit more cautious, and that could have started some type of trouble. I mean, because the card is an action card. It's about planning. It's about making decisions, you know, leaving your comfort zone and taking risk. It's about what you need to do. This person does see you as an individual, the true you. That's what we're on right now. You are an individual who is going to plan. You're going to consider all options. You're going to make sure that you take your time and figure out what you want to do. You are the type of person that needs to have a clearer picture before you proceed. You're not going to let, you know, the fear, there is a fear of the unknown, collective, and you definitely are not going to be one. Ironically, this is a fire card, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, but you're not one that's going to just throw caution to the wind. You're going to definitely be a constant. And when you go in, you want to make sure that you're going for the goal. Unfortunately, this could mean also, because of course we have to look at the reverse of this as well. It also feels like you could be hesitant on things. Like I said, you could be cautious, overly cautious about things that make you afraid. All right. You can be overly cautious. You could be one of those individuals that, you know, are just so slow to move. And I will clarify once I get through all of these, that it makes it impossible. By the time you make your mind up to move forward in something, someone could possibly either not be interested anymore, or there's just this energy of you took too long, if that makes sense. Especially when you give up the eyes for an us and you're not operating anymore based upon what makes you happy. You have to make a decision as a couple or a collective. This is, you know, the true you. All right. Let's move on to the true them. Now, in contrast, the true them is the Ten of Cups. So this person is definitely, first of all, the Ten of Cups is happiness and homecoming and fulfillment and emotional stability and domestic harmony. But when it's describing a person, it means that this person needs, they look at everything through a cup of love. They value home, family, togetherness. Home is where the heart is. This is an individual who feels like they are serious about, this is actually interesting, they are very serious about commitment. They want it all. They don't date around just to date around. When they make their choices, they make their choices. They are looking for the perfect partner because this is who they are. They feel like they have a lot to offer. They feel like everything is about home. This person, actually, it looks like they're looking for the perfect person to build this life with. Now, unfortunately, it could mean that there's chaos. The bad side of the true them is that nothing else exists outside of that. There's more facets to life than just that. I don't want to sound shallow. It could be that this person is overly sensitive. It could be that, you know, the connection could have been filled with family drama. It could be that they're pushing so much for this happy family life that they didn't actually come from a happy family, and they're looking for someone to actually do the heavy lifting. You know, we will clarify intuitively is what this portion is. So I'm feeling like sometimes they may come off not confident, because I feel that if the true them, everything revolves around family, then the very same thing that they hold so high is the very same thing that can create blind spots. For example, the family can do no wrong. Or if the family does do wrong, then this person is so overly focused and super hyper focused on family that nothing happens. There is no end in sight. If they incorporate someone into this family dynamic that they have, no one in their family can do anything wrong. Okay? And that can be a little dangerous. They have to really trust the person that they incorporate into this already family dynamic. This person could already have children. They could have people living in their house with them already, collective. And whatever this situation is, when it comes down to their family, it is good and bad. Because on one hand, that's what you want. You want a person that's going to be all about family, blah, blah, blah. But we don't want to go into something dysfunctional. And I do feel intuitively that this person, their blind spot is definitely their family. Okay. Now, how do they see you? You're coming up as how they see you as the Hangman, which is interesting. The Hangman is the card of sacrifice, surrender, and waiting. You already know that the Hangman is upside down because they need to, you know, view the world from an entirely different perspective. Even though the Hangman symbolically is upside down, the imagery on the card doesn't show any discomfort. This is like, and the halo around the head is to depict the new perspective, right? So, this person sees you as a person who's on a completely different wavelength when it comes down to important life decisions. So I'm already kind of seeing what this is, but it twists when we get down to the rest of these cards, which is interesting. Now, remember, the true you is a Two of Wands type of person. You're going to be slow. And it's not a Knight of Pentacles that's just slow and cautious. This is a Two of Wands type of individual. Okay, we've already went over that. So they kind of are seeing you in that light. So they're seeing you as, you may have different timelines. And again, it can be hard to sync up with you when it comes down to important life decisions. Like I told you, like, you are the type of person, collective, that needs to take your time. You have to plan shit out. You have to strategize, and your timeline on when that's going to happen is your timeline. You're not competing with anybody. With this person already having a family or being a very family-oriented person, and everything that they represent is in the lens of that family dynamic, you can look like you're stalling to this person. You can look like you're taking your time again. And when they're viewing you in the Hangman, they look at you as a person who basically is constantly in upside down enlightenment. They look at you before any steps are taken that you have to, again, be in your Two of Wands that you are, and you need open and honest communication. You basically need to be comforted. It seems like you need to be completely reassured that before you take this next step that nothing is going to happen, which is kind of unrealistic, but I understand where you're coming from. They also see you as someone making a sacrifice. I mean, once you decide, you're all in, but you have to get there. So I believe that in this relationship with you and this person, whomever you're connecting with, you've already showed them that you can make a sacrifice. No matter how grim it may look, you may still be able to sacrifice yourself or sacrifice your fear, which is yourself and your feelings, and move forward. Interesting. You have a way of looking at things in a different perspective that they are not used to. So, to some degree, as it stands now, you guys may have balanced each other out. How you see them is the Four of Wands. That kind of makes sense too, because the true them is a Ten of Cups. Now we know Four of Wands, and we're talking about, you know, more fire energy. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. The card that represented the true them was the Ten of Cups, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. All right, so when we're going into these Four of Wands, you know, Four of Wands obviously is a card of marriage. And it's interesting because it's celebrations of all types, big milestones, but it is depicting a marriage, right? It is marriage and weddings, parties and reunions, and home. So how they come off, like, you guys are seeing each other the way that each other is, which is great. The last reading, it was interesting. This time, you guys are seeing each other pretty much in the same light. You look at this person, collective, as a person that wants to get married. You know that this person may look at you and feel like you're the one. They want you to be a part of this family. They may look at you as a security blanket. They may look at you as a part of their support system. You've been there for them, but you are, I'm sensing by the way that these cards came out, especially with what happened in the past. You are viewing, well, you're seeing them as an individual again, who is wanting to birth a new chapter in their lives with you. They want to get married. They want you to move in. And I don't believe that you are going, I don't believe that this is what you want. And there's a reason why you don't want this. It's not that you don't want this, but there's something that's making you afraid. There's something that's making you apprehensive. There is a reason why they see you as this hangman energy. You know, oh, I cannot wait to clarify this. So you do see them as an individual who may be a little naive, who may put the cart before the horse. Because, you know, I think the flip side of this is that, wait, there's planning that needs to go on. Again, they look at everything, they go off their gut feelings. They go off of their gut. They have a feeling about you. They already love you or feel like you've provided security and that you would make a great partner. You, on the other hand, are a little bit more cautious and a little bit more realistic. And you would have to leave your comfort zone in order to give this person. And I hate to make that sound selfish, but you don't want to jump all the way out the window just to land, you know, land and injure yourself. But you also understand that there's risk that needs to be taken at the same time. Okay. What happened in the past was a Page of Swords. So the card that represents your past is a Page of Swords. We know that the Page of Swords brings obstacles. We know that a Page of Swords, some people say it's the spy card. We know that a Page of Swords is an energy that brings a message, and the message isn't always great, you know, but it is something that's supposed to make us think. You know, the page brings these obstacles and things that we have to focus on. You know, this is the card of communication and curiosity and wit and inspiration and communication, if I didn't say that already. However, a lot of the times I believe what the Page of Swords ends up coming off as is a person that always has to win. A person that always has to be correct. A person that doesn't accept your side of an argument. Winning is more important than feelings. One or both of you guys are looking at each other the other way. I'm going to clarify, but I haven't got to the clarifying part. I feel like there's been miscommunications and mishaps. I feel like there's possessiveness here. I feel like there's been miscommunications. There has been communication between you guys that communication between you guys that has not hit the mark. It didn't land the way it was intended to land. One or both of you may have felt like the other one was spying. One or both of you felt like there's an insecurity that lies between you guys, because one of you, they want to get married collective and you want to take your time and you're not ready. Whether you've communicated this with them, this Page of Swords is showing that you may have tried. They don't see your point. You don't see their point. You guys have a difference of opinion. This is what happened in the past. Present energy shows that it's the Ace of Wands. So, you know, did you guys get back together? The Ace of Wands is a, you know, a brand new passionate beginning. Inspiration, new opportunities, growth, sizzling romantic potential. So it looks like this is going to fare a little bit better than it did last month, because it looks like, you know, if you guys are not in contact, there's going to be some communication. I'm going to get into this, but the Page of Swords of what happened in the past could have been a message of it's over or a breakup. Because the page brings those messages, and they're not always received well. But with this Ace of Wands talking about present energy, there is an energy between you two of opportunities from a romantic point of view. You know, this is the card of chemistry and tension. I feel like someone wants to make up. This is a brand new passionate beginning. So that Page of Swords talking about the past could mean that you guys have broken up. That is how I see it. And the future shows a Wheel of Fortune. So we know that the Wheel of Fortune brings a brand new beginning. The wheel has turned. It is obviously a major arcana. We have our symbolic, the Aquarius and as the angel, the Scorpio as the eagle. We have the Leo as the lion, and we have the Taurus as the bull. This is what goes up must come down. This is stability and wisdom amidst movement. This is the wheel of life and love always changing. This is the card of karma, luck, joy, and life cycles. Well, karma, luck, and life cycles. So that's what we have, guys. Interesting turn of events. This is like a timeline. All right, so let's get back into this. The true you is the Two of Wands. Why is this here, Spirit? Why is the Two of Wands here? The Two of Wands, why is this here? You know that this is a strong bond between you and this individual, the Lovers to the Eight of Pentacles. But at the same time, you still feel like you're being cautious collective, because there's a lot of work to do. You may feel like although you guys have a bond financially, things are not where they need to be individually or together. You do not share the philosophy that, oh, too many came out, but I will take them. You do not share the philosophy with this person that family rules all things. You may have a different perspective when it comes down to family. You may be, or you're coming off a little bit more independent. Family may have completely, you may be isolated from your family, the one that you were born into. You may want to be a little bit selfish because you've been overly given. Right now, you're embarking on some new things financially with the Ace of Pentacles. You're not ready to settle down and incorporate anything with this individual because you feel like you want to get your own things together first. The Strength card also came out indicating that there's been ups and downs between in this relationship and with your money, possibly just with yours or theirs. And you know this. And remember, they look at you as the security blanket. So you do come off much more stable. But there could be some things that you want to do before you get married or move in with this person. Traveling is also a thing with the Six of Swords that you want to do, journey over water, or you could still be in recovery. You feel like there's something between you and this person where it's constant up and down. And you may be feeling like, damn, we just got out of recovery. Why do you want to do this? Like, the way that this is going to play out, especially with this Ace of Wands being present energy and this Page of Swords, when I get there representing the past, whatever happened in the past, if, for you guys that are not together, you are still in recovery mode. This person may come back to you because this is how they see you. And they obviously are going to come back once this wheel turns. They're going to want a new beginning with this Ace of Wands. And you are still recovering from whatever you guys broke up with or whatever the issue was the last time. So this is what I'm feeling for you. And what remains is the Strength card and the Lovers. All right. We move on to the True Them. We move on to the True Them. Why is the Ten of Cups here? Why is the Ten of Cups here? Why is the Ten of Cups here, Spirit? Thank you. Knight of Swords. Yes, so this person has been, wow. They have issues with the way they communicate. It's interesting. There's dynamics in their family with Knight of Swords to the Page of Wands. It feels like when it comes down to communication, that makes sense that this Page of Swords, you left this person because of what they said. They fiercely defend family, as they should. But at the same time, there's some cracks in those walls. What else do we have, Spirit? The Queen of Wands. They're extremely passionate about you. This Queen of Wands matches the Two of Wands, which is the true you. They are completely turned on by your passion, by your ability to make a dollar out of 15 cents. Again, you are a hustler. You are a go-getter. That's because of your cautiousness and your planning. And they're aware of that. But they still, they will defend this Ten of Cups to the umpteen. They will defend it to the umpteen degree with this Knight of Swords. They have not always been the nicest. They come off as an individual too, who is bound to their family by fault. The family that they made, the family that they were born into, and pushing this so much to this family issue or this family so much to the point where it, again, has created blind spots. Because I'm all really feeling intuitively, especially with this Knight of Swords, that they're so busy defending that they're missing what needs to be fixed. So I understand your cautiousness, okay? Yeah, they're on their way back, though. Page of Wands, Knight of Swords to the Page of Wands to the Queen of Wands. The Queen and the Page are family. This person should either already has a child or children, and wants you to come in and be the other parent dynamic. When they look at you, collective, they look at you as someone who definitely can come in and make that house a home, okay? They definitely can make that you can make that house a home. All right. How do they see you is the energy of the Hangman. Why is the Hangman here, Spirit? Why is the Hangman here? No major arcanas with that other card. All right. Too many, but we're going to take them. We do have the Fool. The Fool was in reverse. So they're looking at you. They know that you're being cautious right now. You are not trying to move forward. The Fool in reverse. You don't want to throw caution to the wind. That's the opposite of what the hell you are. You are in the Two of Wands. This is who you are as a person. And you're not so the Fool energy, throwing caution to the wind and moving forward with risk and reward, looking at it through the glass half empty of Fool and all of that. You're not into that. You want to stay put and play it safe until you know without a doubt, when sometimes you know and sometimes you don't, that this is the right thing to do. It is a good card to move forward, but you have to be sure. You have to have a plan and a strategy. To the Two of Cups, you are acknowledging your feelings for them. To the Queen of Cups, to the Four of Wands. Yeah, you're acknowledging that they are someone that you would mind being with. You would love to explore this, but this person, your timeline and this person's timeline is not the same thing. And you're not going to allow them to intimidate you or push you forward quicker than you want. Okay, they want, or whatever this is, okay? The major arcana is the Fool in reverse. Two of Cups is here. Queen of Cups. This person, you guys have a bond, and they love you, collective, and it looks like you love them back. Four of Wands is here. You know what they want, but it doesn't look like you guys have done much talking about it, okay? How you see them is that same Four of Wands that just came out for you. So, of course, you see them in the Four of Wands. Why is this Four of Wands here, Spirit? Why is the Four of Wands here? We got the Hermit, the King of Pentacles. Interesting. Give me one more. Okay. So with the King of Pentacles, this is someone who could be a business owner. This is someone who isolated themselves. They had to isolate themselves due to some things that has happened to them. They're a business owner. Maybe they manage several things. They know what they want. They are financially set. If they're not set financially, they definitely have abundance at their fingertips that they manage and they create. They trust you, collective. And there was some point in the past where they kind of just, with this Hermit energy, they searched for wisdom. They could have manifested you after this relationship was over, because I am seeing that this was some type of breakdown or breakup. I am seeing that they have been in an energy of, you know, taking time alone, taking time out by themselves to spend time alone to figure out what they want. This could, for some of you, resonate in a way where they didn't always have this, and this may be a surprise that they feel this way because you walked away. But I'm having a hard time feeling that that is it. You definitely broke up, but you knew when you left this individual that this person was a Ten of Cups and a Four of Wands type of person. We're gonna get into what you guys broke up for, what happened in the past next, but I don't think that it's a surprise that this person will want to marry you. I do think that communication is your biggest issue. And then we have the Sun. You make them happy. That's the reason why the Four of Wands is here. And this is why you see them this way. They obviously made you happy at some point too, collective, okay? I just think that when it comes down to the timeline, you guys were not on the same page, okay? Now we're going to get into the nitty and the gritty, and that's the Page of Swords, which is representing what happened in the past. So there was some type of communication breakdown that came in, and I suspect that there was a breakup. Clarify this. Tell me why this is here. So we have the Ten of Wands. So it became burdensome. You guys, your communications, your arguments, it became burdensome. Yes, to the Ace of Swords. And there was a revelation either on one or both of you. Collective, I'm feeling like you were the one that ended this, honestly. Why is this here? Give me one more. Thank you, Spirit. Yep. With the King. So the Ten of Wands to the Ace of Swords to the Ten of Cups. So you knew that this person had an offer. Take it as it resonates. I believe that it became too overwhelming for you, that you guys were on two totally different, you were on two totally different time frames. And take the side as it resonates as well, guys, because I know that you're probably like, nope, I'm the other side. That's fine. It became too burdensome. I feel like one side was resisting. When are we going to do this? Solidifying anything, making things official. And the other side was like, look, I want marriage. I know what I want. Can we talk about this? I have this offer. Let's get married. What are we waiting for? And I don't feel like that was ever told. I think that this was a prime reason is that there was no working together. There was no, yep. The chemistry is fantastic, but I just feel like, and I'm going to actually clarify this with some oracle cards too. I just don't feel like when it came down to communication. Someone definitely was afraid, and I don't feel like it came, it was communicated the way that it needed to be communicated. And this page is letting me know that there was just a lot of truth that wasn't told. Death at the top of the deck. I'm sorry, death underneath the Three of Pentacles. Give me something else, Spirit. Let me know what went wrong. So we got detachment. Yes, I had to let this go so I can clear my mind. Somebody walked away. And collective, I feel like it's you. You definitely had to walk away. And it also could be that you looked at them as somebody that you wanted to marry. And although you do see them as the Ten of Cups and you see them as this Four of Wands, the true them is the Ten of Cups. So you saw that deep down they were this family-oriented person you were in love with. And then you see them as a person you can marry. Doesn't necessarily mean that they wanted to get married. So I could be changing it just because it's coming out for them that that is what the true them is and how you see them. Doesn't necessarily mean that they were pushing marriage. They could have been going in the exact opposite, and you could have wanted to be married, and you could have been the one that was, you know, the energies can definitely be reversed, although the energies are out here. I'm just saying. The other card is damage. We are both hurting from this. So you guys are needing to talk about your timeline and then values. Yep, we have too many differences. However, top of the deck, we still have things to resolve and discuss. And the bottom of the deck, I don't know if we will ever change. So these oracle cards are coming out stating that there is definitely some things that you guys need to sit down and discuss. And every time you guys attempted to do that, that page of swords would come out and the message just wouldn't land right. I also feel like some of you guys just didn't get the damn answers that you want. Someone didn't want to tell you because they were afraid that they would lose you if they let the other person know what was going on. Give me three more, Spirit. I pulled away because I'm overwhelmed with all of the things that is going on in my life. Well, that definitely showed. That came out with the Ten of Wands. I'm planning on reaching out to you. Okay, that's this Ace of Wands, although we haven't got there yet. Give me one more, Spirit, for why this fell apart. What happened in the past? I don't know what I want. Yeah, this person, either you to them or them to you, okay, at this point. Somebody doesn't know what they want. The marriage scares them. It just is what it is. Top of the deck is I feel you. Right under that is I love you. And the bottom of the deck, I feel empty without you. So you walked away. You definitely walked away. They could be one of those individuals who, as much as a family person as they are, that family has been, you know, down their damn throat so much that they just feel like they want to be free. They could be one of those, you know, people that have to take care of somebody in their family and, you know, having to deal with family. They're trying to run away from their damn family and you want to make one. Doesn't make it right or wrong, just saying. Okay, so this is what I'm seeing here. No major arcana. Let's get into present energy is in the Ace of Wands. So after there's been some type of separation between you. Thank you, Spirit. Okay. All right, so this person has been in quiet contemplation. Clarifying this Ace of Wands. There's been a lot of fighting, conflict, quarreling, competition. Four swords to the Five of Wands to the Six of Swords. We're in recovery. Now you were in recovery. That came out to clarify your energy. And now the present energy is showing recovery. And there is an Eight of Wands here as well that came out. So there's going to be quick moving communication. I've already told you that this person is going to be reaching out. I still feel like, you know, there definitely are things that are left unsaid here. But I think that after some time, how much time? We got a four, we got a six, we got a five, we got an eight. Either one of those timelines, for some of you, it's been 4 months. Some of you, it's been 5 months. Some of you, it has been 6 months. Some of you, it's been 8 months. Or half of these, okay? Half of six is three. Half of the five is 2.5. Half of the four is two. Half of the eight is four. That's how long you guys have been apart, either one of those numbers. And I do feel like they're going to be reaching out because they want a brand new beginning and they want you guys to make up. They feel like enough is enough. There's too much love here. Okay. And then finally, we do have the Wheel of Fortune as the future. So the wheel is turning. Maybe you guys needed to experience this apart. Tell me why the wheel is here. We do have the Queen of Pentacles. Now, there was already a King of Pentacles that came out when I clarified one of the other cards. So there is a Divine Feminine here. And what is this? Yep, there is the wheel. The wheel clarifying the wheel. So this is over with. This cycle is turning. And then, yep, there we go. We got the Ten of Cups. So we basically, all roads lead back to this Ten of Cups. Okay? All roads lead back to this Ten of Cups. And this is exactly what we got. This is like an all roads leads back to the Ten of Cups part two. I named the video that a long time ago. And that's what this is. I feel like this is going to be coming back around, guys, honestly. Top of the deck is the Knight of Pentacles. Bottom in the, yep. We are coming out of mental frustration, mental fear, mental restriction. And now we're going to be going into an energy of clarity. Ten of Cups clarifies the Ten of Cups. Wheel of Fortune clarifies the damn Wheel of Fortune. Can't make that up. And then the Queen of Pentacles is being clarified. It's clarifying the Wheel of Fortune, but there was a King of Pentacles that came out a couple of cards ago. So I feel like that is the Divine Masculine and Feminine. This is beautiful. So this is going to be, you guys are going to be reconciling after a while. Let's go into the Romance Angel Oracle cards and see if I can get any clarifiers before we close you out. Beautiful energy here tonight and how they see you. So for some of you guys, there's going to be some Mercury retrograde makeups. Keep an open mind. Your soulmate may differ from your usual type and expectation. All right. What else do we have, Spirit? We have, yep, reconciliation. Can't make that up, guys. Someone from the past is returning. That's what I said. And then what was this? We do have... I can't even make it up. Unrequited love is in reverse. I'm not making that up. I promise to God it is in reverse. Wow. So yes, there used to be some unrequited love. You guys didn't think you were compatible. There was a lot of burdens. But the worst card on this spread is the Page of Swords. It could have been a lot worse even when I clarified it, and it still wasn't. Healing family issues is at the top of the deck, and let go of control issues is in the past. I can't make it up. Let's go over these major arcanas and get you out of here. The Fool is in reverse, but it is still here. We got the Hermit upright. We got the Sun. We got the Lovers, and we got Strength. I think that this is definitely where you guys have went. The Lovers indicates your bond. The Strength indicates the struggle. The Fool in reverse gives me a little bit of insight on why you guys couldn't move forward. You know, then we got the Sun indicating the level of happiness and enlightenment and love that you share, and the Hermit, which I think both of you guys have been in Hermit mode. Major arcanas in the main spread is Hangman and the Wheel of Fortune. Wow. So the Wheel of Fortune is indicating the future. And I think all roads lead back to this Ten of Cups, because this Ten of Cups came out twice, but I love this for you guys. I like it. This was a really good way to end the year. We'll see what January's brings, but this was a really good one. Like, share, and subscribe to the Marvelous Tribe. Everything you need is below in the description box for you and your collective, guys. And I will see you when you start getting your uploads from the 10th through the 17th. We did a reading that is called What's the Tea? Can't wait to give you guys those. See you soon, guys. Bye-bye.